John, that's a good angle. Yep. Keep going. Keep going. Oh, hey, teleprompter's on. Turn it off. Turn it off. Turn it off. Turn it off.
You're tuned in to Kaz TV.
Kamala Harris recently did a town hall with Univision, and it's gone viral, but not for the reasons that she would like. If you look closely at this clip, you see something unexpected, a teleprompter.
And sadly, we have seen over the last 2 weeks since Hurricane Helene.
Now, town halls are supposed to be candid conversations between politicians and the people, not scripted performances. So the question is, what's going on here? Immediately, social media erupted with accusations that this is a scripted interview and it's all fake. This reinforced the perception that she prefers scripted interviews and a controlled environment. But before jumping to conclusions, let's break down what both sides are saying about what's going on. Many on the right argue that the presence of a teleprompter proved that she can't do these type of interviews. Conservative commentators argue that the presence of the teleprompter fits the pattern that people have recognized. Now, on the other hand, Univision stepped in and said the teleprompter wasn't for Harris. They said it was for the moderator. They said it contained Spanish cues and timers to help guide him through the event smoothly. Now, whether that's true or not, who knows? But that's what Univision, the group that was running the town hall, said. This is what most people perceive was going on.
Yeah, John, that's a good angle.
Are you okay?
Keep going.
And
keep going. Oh, hey, teleprompter's on. Turn it off. Turn it off. Turn it off. Turn it off.
Since Hurricane Helene, and now in the immediate after.
Now, whether that's true or not, who knows? But that's the public's perception. And all it takes is one seed of doubt. But here's where perception matters. Once a seed of doubt is planted, it's hard to uproot that. This moment adds fertilizer to that seed of doubt that a lot of Americans have about Kamala, which is, she is a scripted politician.
How are you going to pay for that?
Okay, so the other economists that have reviewed my plan versus my opponent and determined that my economic plan would strengthen America's economy, his would weaken it. But my plan, Bill, if you don't mind, my plan is about saying that when you invest in small businesses, you invest in the middle class, and you strengthen America's economy. Small businesses are part of the backbone of America's economy.
But pardon me, Madam Vice President. The question was, how are you going to pay for it?
Well, one of the...
Again, that's not saying that she is. That's saying that's what the perception is. Most of us have never met any of these politicians in real life, so we really don't know. But that's what the perception is. And that perception makes a difference in the polls.
New polls are out, and it doesn't look good for Kamala Harris. I have not been this worried in a long time. So we don't have a lot of time left. We have less than a month left, and she's now losing in almost all the swing states. So I'm going to go break down all the numbers for you guys. They don't look great. I'm going to give you what people in D.C. are saying, Democratic Party are saying, Republican pollsters, everyone across the board, how are the markets doing, et cetera. First, look, I'm telling you this, not again to ha-ha or whatever. I'm telling you because the pundits are almost always wrong. They never come back and tell you, oh, yeah, we got it wrong, et cetera. They don't tell you oftentimes ahead of time. They do Monday morning quarterback. They've, you know, all those different things that they do wrong. The reason I tell you guys stuff ahead of time is so you can see whether I'm right or not. So you can see whether you should trust our analysis of what is reality, not what we want, but what is reality. So that's why in that context, let me tell you, 4 days ago, this weekend on October 5th, I wrote, I think Trump is going to retake the lead. Kamala started playing prevent defense with too small a lead. By having her surrogates tell everyone how pro-business she is, she accidentally gave up the mantle of the change candidate. That's what's going to decide this election. Now, she did other things wrong, too, and I'll get into that in a second. But I started getting the same sense over the weekend that I got the weekend before the 2016 election. You go back and you read my tweets from that weekend from, November, early November of 2016, and I start saying, oh, boy, a lot of signs are looking bad. I know Hillary Clinton has a big lead, but I'm super worried. Every spidey sense I have, every poll, every anecdote, not poll, the polls were mixed, okay, and Hillary Clinton was leading in the polls overall, but the underlying numbers were scaring me. So all of those things were leading me to go, watch out, warning. You remember what I said on election night in 2016 over and over again, brace for impact, right? And so I hate to say that to you right now, and there's still plenty of time to turn it around, not plenty of time, but some time. And I think she can turn it around because it's not like it's over. It's not like it's a blowout. No, she's got a small disadvantage in the swing states, but it is definitely a disadvantage. So let me start breaking it down for you.
In recent polls, Harris's favorability hasn't been looking that great. And events like these, whether they're misunderstandings or not, only add fuel to the fire. For voters on the fence, moments like this can reinforce the idea that she's not the most authentic or trustworthy candidate. To be clear, I'm not here to attack Harris. I'm just trying to explain how moments like these do impact public perception. In politics, we know that perception is everything, whether it's true or not. And right now, this controversy, whether it's true or not, fair or not, this fits into the existing narrative about Kamala Harris. So what do you think? Was this just a misunderstanding? Was it a teleprompter situation that was meant for the host of the event? Or does it reflect a deeper issue with her inability to connect with voters? Let me know what you think in the comments. Make sure to share, like, and subscribe. Thanks for checking out this video.